It's 3 o'clock now. So I welcome everybody who has joined this Zoom meeting. And first of all, thank you, Mr. Colgood, for doing this. And I'm very glad that we could do this in person.
Sure. Definitely.
After a very long time, I'm not my family members I'm meeting for
after
a very long time.
True.
So to start with, I'll briefly introduce Mr. Amit Colgood. Mr. Colgood and I are acquaintance since 2 years now. By chance, we met each other.
Yes.
He had some requirement regarding filtration system, so he happened to call me. And then through our interactions, many things have revealed. So, about Mr. Colgood. So, he has done his master's in the US, and he's a chemical engineer, and he is part of Society of Tribologies and Lubrications from the US. And amazingly, you have worked for a lot of dream companies like Gillette and Samsung and Johnson & Johnson, and now you are here in India, heading as technical director of Polychem. So welcome, and I would request you to now tell us about Polychem, what they do.
Sure.
And
thank you, Ajinkya, for having me. Just to give you a brief background about myself, I did my bachelor's in chemical engineering. I passed out in 1997. In 1998, for 1 year, I did my internship in National Chemical Laboratory in Pune. And in 98, I applied for master's in the University of Massachusetts. But at that time, you must have remembered that the Pokhran trials were taken for nuclear engineering or nuclear field. At that time, because my master's is into chemical and nuclear engineering.
Oh.
So I had a tough time getting a visa. Because I was tall. All my friends had gone, got the visa, and they had flown to the US. And I was waiting because of that. But after a background check, they gave me the visa. So I did my master's in University of Massachusetts in chemical and nuclear engineering.
When was this?
This was in 98. So in 2000, I passed out. And then in 2000, I joined Parker Comerix, the company, and where I was in research department into conducting polymers, where we basically was doing research on conducting polymers, which is put on the cell phones.
Okay.
So whatever heat has been generated in the cell phones is being transmitted as a sink to that conducting polymers. So I worked there for 5 years. After that, I changed my job and I basically joined Freudenberg NOK.
Okay.
I think here also in Pune, we have their branch. That's into automotive elastomers. So we have pretty good knowledge, and R&D was done on elastomers. So that was my job. After Freudenberg, basically, I worked there for 5 years. So 10 years had passed. And I had this passion that I want to, go back to India one day. But what happens when people go there, they get a green card, they get a citizenship.
Correct.
And people usually don't come back. But I had this passion that I want to come back. Simultaneously, my wife, Kranti, she has also done her master's into administration in MBA and an MS and a master's into IT. So we both wanted to come back and do something for the country. So at that time, after 10 or 12 years, we came back to India, and I joined Polychem as a technical director.
So Polychem was already in existence?
Yes, my father basically founded Polychem, and he was a vice principal and head of department chemistry in Ferguson College. So that was a passion he had for chemistry. And the same passion was indulging me. So I joined the company with a very good motive that my father is also going to be of helping me in the business. But unfortunately, the same year when we came, my parents were met with an accident.
Oh.
And within 1 year, they expired.
Sorry.
So it was like, why did I come back? Because there was no purpose for me to stay back. So me and my wife had thoughts that we will go back. US, already we have a green card. So we said that, but then we said the passion which we had was there, and there was no one to guide. But we both said we will, set our feet here and start from scratch. It was like our company was very small at that time. We had a 500 square feet shop floor in Kothur. So we said, like, you know, what to do. And then we thought over it, and our people also, the employees were also very helpful. And they gave us the motivation. Our employees gave us the motivation to basically stay back. So we stayed back. There were a lot of fights, a lot of ups and downs. But I think it was a good decision, because the passion to work for our country, to make products here, was that basically drove me to stay back. And so we now are 10 years in India. And hopefully, I think we are doing pretty well. Now we have moved to in Pirangut, where we have a 27,000 square feet plant.
Wow.
And so God has been kind. So.
And about Polychem, so we'll discuss in detail, but can you just let us know, or let everybody know, what exactly, what are the products of Polychem?
Yes. Basically, Polychem, the whole foundation we have is that we want to support or help our customers. So we are in the field of metal working fluids that comprise of machining coolants, rust preventive oils, washing chemicals, and many tailor-made products. So when I say tailor-made, it's basically to satisfy or to solve a customer's problem or challenge. That is our USP.
Mm.
So we are into all these fields for many years.
Okay. And some of the, I mean, you mentioned there are some tailor-made products that you made. So can you just elaborate? For me, it is quite easy to say that we customize our product because we fabricate those.
Correct.
When it comes to chemicals, how do you customize?
Yes. For example, the main, my focus is basically into import substitutes. So there are many MNCs who have come in the past 20 years in India, have set up their big plants. And these people are importing chemicals or lubricants from their own country, like Belgium or Switzerland or US or Germany. So my focus is, how can we make it in India and give them that kind of quality?
Okay.
Now, the advantage of make in India is just not to, you know, have a, you know, saying that make in India, but the ingredients which we are using are also totally Indian. Okay. For example, our coolants are not using mineral oils.
Okay.
Very less amount. There we are using vegetable oils.
Okay.
Our washing chemicals are not using, you know, like heavy or high alkaline chemicals, but we are using coconut oils.
Oh.
So these, and India is basically an agriculture country. So we want, and our main, India is thriving on agriculture. And farmers is our main, you know, we all are farmers, if you say that. So they are growing these crops. So how about we make formulations from those?
Hmm.
That's the focus.
Wow.
Because if you don't go with mineral oil, then, you know, I'm not saying it's a big dent, but at least from our angle, we are, you know, trying to make a dent in the GDP.
Correct.
So the import subsidy is one. And there are many other innovative products which we do in our segments.
Okay. Amazing. Yeah, the thought of, just the thought that somehow to use whatever is available to us and then solve industry problems, I think that itself is quite innovative.
Yes.
I personally, I don't know whether there are other companies who are of this, are of similar thinking, that why not use whatever available resources are there in our country and then make some innovative products out of it.
Correct.
Most of the import substitutions that I have seen, they are just, I mean, we get the raw material from outside and then basically, it is just reducing the cost.
Correct,
that is what import substitution means generally.
Exactly.
But this is something new.
Yes.
So I think now we will drill a little deeper and we'll segment our discussion on various metal working fluids, starting with washing chemicals.
Yes.
So during our interaction earlier, you mentioned that because of these recent BS6 norms, there has been some change in usage behavior when it comes to these washing chemicals. Mm-hmm. Can you just elaborate on, on that?
Now, you must have known that BS4, India was on BS3, BS4 level. Now, what has happened is the new government, we decided to go to BS6. So that means we're totally skipping one level and going to BS6 norms. So that is equivalent to Euro 6 norms. And for that, the whole purpose is to have, you know, less pollution. That is the whole thing. But just going overnight to BS6, skipping BS4 is very much strenuous to the engine manufacturers. Now, for example, one IC engine has 10,800 moving parts. So there are vendors, there are sub-vendors who are basically making these parts. So the parts are basically forged, then they're machined, and then they're cleaned. So when you clean a part, each of the supplier or the vendor has been given a millipore value. A millipore is basically a company in US which makes millipore filters.
Okay.
And this filter is basically, or this millipore value is the is basically going to calculate the amount of dirt.
It is like the unit.
Unit to calculate dirt in the component. So for example, on a particular component, say 10 milligrams per liter is the dirt level expected in BS4. Now it has come to 1.2.
Wow.
So now that vendor or the manufacturer has to have the component pristine clean before he gives it to the OEM. Because the OEM will assemble everything and then have a combined millipore of the system. So now it's left, there's nothing left to, you know, do. So people are using harsh chemicals.
Oh.
They started using trichloroethylene, the solvents, then MTO and xylene and all these products. Because these are hazardous chemicals, but they give good cleaning.
Good cleaning.
But, and they're also very costly.
Okay.
So in here, when we came in this, our whole proposition is that why not make a water-based washing chemical, which will clean and give results equivalent to kerosene or MTO.
Okay.
Now, for example, this kerosene or MTO is going to cost, say, 70-80 rupees a liter. And if we give a water-based product, it's going to be like 10 to 15 rupees only.
Okay.
So, excellent cost advantage, safety, then no fire or flash point, and the millipores are going to be excellent. So, and this can be achieved only by using, you know, vegetable oils.
Okay.
So, all our products are in that, you know, arena. And so we are having many products which are giving this excellent millipore values.
Okay.
So, and which is, the customers are happy because the millipore values have come down.
So, when you talk about millipores, what is the procedure of knowing this millipore value?
Yes. Millipore values, like if you take a component and then you take heptane, 1 liter of heptane. And if the procedure says that with 1 liter of heptane, you wash this component. And whatever that used heptane, by washing the component, you have to collect and then filter it through a millipore paper, a 4 micron or 2 micron paper. And then whatever is, and then the paper is clean initially. And then after, when they filter this out, there is some dirt on the filter. So that dirt before and after weight, say it is like 2 milligram. So it's 2 milligram per liter of heptane.
Okay.
So that 2 milligram is the millipore value.
Oh, okay.
So they want to have these products very, because these, I'm not saying that only this washing or cleanliness is one way to get BS6, but there are many other ways.
Correct.
Like excellent fuel quality, reduced sulfur levels.
Correct.
Then you know, there are many things. But from our part,
from the engine cleaning point of view, millipore value is
very important.
So this, I mean, is the 1.2 mg per liter, is it sort of regulated or is it sort of industry practice to maintain that?
Industry practice. Depending on which customer they have, depending on what their OEM is telling them to do.
Okay. And this 1.2, is it like a, I mean, do people who, like auto component manufacturers, do they know that they have to maintain this?
Yes, yes. Like 1.2, I'm just giving an example because there are bigger components have different millipore values. Each component has their own specific values.
Achha. Okay.
But they are like reduced now. I'm just saying this in the scale of, first 10 was accepted, now they have to go to
over. Okay. So there is a 90%.
80-90% reduction has been expected.
Okay. And is this, I mean, are these BS6 norms only for passenger vehicles or even for commercial or?
Commercial vehicles, everybody.
Okay.
Everybody. Right now, excluding the planes.
Okay.
Everybody has to go on BS6.
Okay. So, but I think aerospace already they would be much beyond these norms.
Correct. And when these norms come in place, the main thing is cost, which ultimately the user or common like people like us have to bear it.
Correct. So, on one end, we see that, I mean, cleanliness is expected through these chemicals. But what happens when, first of all, how to decide whether a chemical is still useful or it is time to discard it?
Yes.
How to decide that?
Yes. In washing chemical, if you see, the main thing is people use the washing chemicals anywhere from 1 month to 6 months.
Okay.
Now, people or customers ask us, like, when should we discard our washing chemical? But our question to them is, it depends on how many components you're washing. For example, today you're washing 100 components. And tomorrow, next month, you're washing only 20 components. So they don't know when to discard it. So usually the practice is that when they start getting higher millipores, they discard it. But we tell our customers that there are many ways to look at the chemical which we test. The first thing we see is the pH. Now for alkaline washing chemicals, they have to maintain a pH of 9 to 9.5. Second is the bacterial growth or the fungi growth inside. Because usually people say we are getting a foul smell. That is connected to the bacterial growth. That they have to check. Third is that each month they have to, you know, keep on adding different biocides which we do in our concentrates so that the bacteria don't grow. Fourth important is the oil removal, because cleaning means you're removing a soluble oil or a neat oil from the component. So that oil removal is extremely important with the help of filters, skimmers or anything. So if that is not removed, then it forms a layer on the top of the tank and the coolant cannot breathe. Like as we say, we need to breathe. So the coolant or the washing chemical has to breathe. And if the oil layer is going to form a layer, then there is no dissolved oxygen inside. And so it starts to suffocate and then it starts to, you know, give foul smell, rusting issues, corrosion, all these things happen. But oil has to be removed very, very effectively. That is very mandatory. So these all parameters has to be checked.
Okay.
If filtration is not feasible because of the way the machine is made, then you can have external filtration. So many sump cleaners or other innovative products have come. So, but we have to clean the
keep the chemical clean.
Yes, okay. That is very important.
There is a request that if we can speak in Hindi, I know it won't be very comfortable for both of us.
Yeah.
But I think we'll.
Fine, we'll do mix.
We'll, yeah.
Fine.
So you mentioned that there are some products or chemicals which are currently being used in making these washing chemicals. And there are some MPCB norms or not MPCB, pollution control board norms, which are getting stricter or they are getting very stringent.
Right.
So first of all, what are these norms? And how do these chemicals, like current use of these chemicals is not, I mean, how can,
correct,
there is a, we need to achieve a balance in that.
Right. See, MPCB, Maharashtra Pollution Control Board, or in any state, they have Pollution Control Board. And as a chemical manufacturer or a industry, MSME, I would say, not only chemical, but any industry, it is mandatory that we follow all the rules or the regulations what they have given. Because the MPCB norms are very nicely written and they have clearly spelled out what is expected. So basically, and also our customers like, say, Cummins, Tata Motors, they have given us a banned list of chemicals, which is also implemented in US.
Okay.
So when we have a list of banned chemicals, we know that these chemicals are not supposed to be used while formulating. So because, for example, trichloroethylene, very commonly used. Then you have xylene, very commonly used. So these are the washing chemicals which are used. They give excellent results, no doubt. But with trichloroethylene use, there is a lot of chances of getting cancer.
Oh.
It's substitute, the chlorine substitutes in your lungs and you can get, the operators can get lung cancer or whatever.
I think if you can just tell this point in Hindi, it would be especially this point.
Sure. Trichloroethylene, jo hai, agar wo hum use karte hai, aur usse result behtar milte hai, sasta hota hai, but usse agar operators ko ya jo log kaam kar rahe hai, unko agar cancer hone ki possibility hai, to wo use karna mana hai. Ya aap agar xylene use kar rahe ho cleaning ke liye, पता है कि जाइलिन फास्ट इवेपोरेटिंग है और क्लीनिंग बहुत अच्छा करता है, पर अगेन उसका फ्लैश पॉइंट बहुत कम है, सो अगेन सेफ्टी हजार्ड है. तो इसकी वजह से गवर्नमेंट पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल बोर्ड ने बहुत नॉर्म्स दिए हैं विच वी हैव टू स्ट्रिक्टली फॉलो. थोड़ा इनकन्वीनियंस होता है बट दैट्स ओके. वी हैव टू यू नो मैनेज इन दैट एंड डू इट. तो ये जो केमिकल्स हैं दे आर ऑल सब्स्टिट्यूट्स टू केरोसिन, एमटीओ, ज़ाइलीन, सब सब्स्टिट्यूट है
आपके जो प्रोडक्ट्स हैं.
व्हाट वी आर डूइंग एंड अगेन बिकॉज़ ये सब सॉल्वेंट्स आर कमिंग फ्रॉम अब्रॉड व्हिच इज अगेन क्रूड एंड अगेन इंपोर्ट एंड अगेन डॉलर्स. सो वी आर मेकिंग अवर कंट्री वीक. सो वी हैव गुड सब्स्टिट्यूट्स, नॉट पॉलीकेम बट एवरीबॉडी हैज सब्स्टिट्यूट्स बट एस्पेशियली पॉलीकेम हैज वेजिटेबल ऑयल बेस्ड. सो दैट्स आवर यूएसपी. आफ्टर यूजिंग, यूज करने के बाद ये केमिकल्स को आप यू नो पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल में ट्रीट कर सकते हैं ईटीपी में, एफ्लुएंट ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट में. एंड देन फॉर द नॉर्म्स यू कैन यू नो द वाटर जो है यू कैन स्प्रे टू गार्डन एंड यूज इट एंड व्हाट एवर इज रिमेनिंग कैन गिव टू द गवर्नमेंट और कॉर्पोरेशन फॉर दैट. सो देयर आर मेनी वेज ऑफ डूइंग इट.
सो व्हेन इट अगर हम पॉलीकेम के केमिकल्स के बारे में बात करें, सो आपका कुछ रिकमेंडेशन ऐसा है कि देयर एक्स वाई जेड स्टेप्स नीड टू बी फॉलोड या ईटीपी में ऐसे ट्रीट करना है यूज केमिकल्स को? सो इज देयर एनी?
नहीं, यूज केमिकल कोई भी हो, अल्कलाइन होता है तो उसको न्यूट्रल करना पड़ेगा.
ओके.
अगर एसिडिक है तो अगेन उसमें कॉस्टिक वगैरह डाल के उसको न्यूट्रल करना पड़ेगा. एंड द नॉर्म्स आर द प्रोसीजर हैज बीन ऑलरेडी डिफाइंड बाय ऑल पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल बोर्ड्स.
ओके.
सो दैट ईटीपी प्रोसेस इज डिफाइंड एंड यू हैव टू फॉलो दैट.
ओके.
आई रिक्वेस्ट कि कोई उसको बाईपास ना करे.
So, many a times what happens is small companies like us, we can't afford to have big ETPs or wastewater treatment plants.
Right.
So, what can small companies do in?
Yeah, in this wastewater, for that you can have a very small plant like 100 kg capacity also. That is not very expensive. But if a company does not want to, then there are a list of vendors from pollution control board who can come and take that waste.
Okay.
And they will charge you something per liter and they will treat it.
Achha.
That is also one way of doing it.
Yeah, this is a, I think this is a very important trend.
Yes.
Earlier, let's say 10 years back when we just started, I used to hear that I will just throw it away.
Yes, exactly.
We'll just put it in the drain.
Correct.
But now, slowly but surely, this awareness, this behavior, I think this is a very important behavior change.
Yes. And people have to accept this change as change is the only constant. We accept karna padega, kyunki if we want to compete with the Chinese people or Americans, agar compete karna hai wahan pe, toh we have to be at the world standard.
Correct.
We have to go to world standard. And the whole drive of Polychem is to go to world class.
Correct.
How can we approach world class? So that is our goal.
Correct.
So all the norms, the all these things has to be followed.
Yeah, I mean, India is known for implementing Jugaad.
Yes.
And in many cases, Jugaad is innovative.
Yes.
There is no doubt.
Yes.
But Jugaad will save you money, but definitely it is not enough to make you a world class organization.
Correct. Jugaad will save money, but if you want to be world class, only one thing which works is systems.
Correct.
System, system, and system. So in Polychem also, we are also a small medium company. In that also, we have now invested into SAP.
Oh.
SAP HANA. It's very costly, but that gives you a standard.
Mm.
Like my wife was instrumental in you know implementing SAP, but that gives a world class standard. So if you want to be world class, Jugaad will not work.
Correct.
Jugaad will save money for the time being.
Hmm.
But if any folk want to compete in like say Guangzhou or any other company and when they come for visit and they see your systems, then they want to work with you.
Correct.
And for exporting products, you need all these things in place.
Okay. So right now, I mean, as a as an external, let's say, if you are competing on a world stage, who would you think is the number one competitor for you in terms of the country? I mean,
see now, as you said the word competition. Now, see there was two definitions of competition: pre-COVID and post-COVID. Era has been you know ended. So, पहले कैसे था कि ये मेरा कंप्यूटर है, ये कितने में बेच रहा है, मैं कितने में बेचूं? You know that was the whole thing. But now I think that now the world will be a world of collaboration.
Mm.
So you have to unitedly work together. Say one competitor has a X product which is fantastic. You have one product which is fantastic. So if you know, you can learn from each other and collaborate.
Correct.
That is going to help our country grow. Say for example, Americans do innovations. Like this is like, you know, for our industry, like lubricant industry is that. There are, I'll not take the brand names, but American products, our people will pay say 400 rupees per liter. Why? No, it's American. It's worldwide approved, worldwide. Now if an Indian company asks say 200 rupees for a machining coolant, they say, nahi, bahut mehenga hai. Nahi chalega yaar, wo nahi. But 400 rupees they'll give it to them. So Joe, this and this mentality is, yes, of course the performance is there, but our performance maybe is not exactly same, but we are not less than, you know, 90% of that.
Okay.
But we are giving an excellent quality. 10 years back, it was a case that, yes, there was a vast difference. But now, there is no difference in quality also.
Okay.
So, we have to come out from the mentality imported is excellent and Swadeshi is not good. Now, we have to change all these things.
Correct.
And we have to go with our products only.
Correct.
That is going to save our economy.
Very important point.
Yes.
There is a question. Yeah.
You are all are discussing in many good points, which is very beneficial for all of the customers and the dealers who are doing right now in this meeting.
Okay.
Can you please talk in Hindi, explain in Hindi?
Okay, okay, we will.
You can unable to understand the English language.
Fine, fine.
Sure.
Hindi language.
Okay.
The thing is, there are many people from South India as well. So they won't understand Hindi. So that is the main reason why we are mainly conversing in English.
But we try to do it both.
Huh. We'll try to mix it up.
Yeah. Yeah.
So yes. There is a question from Mr. Joyjeet Singh. He's asking, what should be the hardness of water for the best use of cleaning chemicals?
See.
So I'll just repeat in Hindi. Mr. Joyjeet Singh pooch rahe hai ki jo paani aap cleaning chemicals ke liye use karte ho, mixing ke liye. उसका हार्डनेस कितना होना चाहिए?
See, the required hardness should be drinking water is the best. Okay, but बहुत सारे जो industries है, वो DM water में जाते हैं, because they want to be the best. But DM water में जाते हैं, तो you understand one thing कि cleaning chemicals में जैसे water DM और soft होता है, जितना soft होता है, you get lot of foaming.
Oh.
Foaming is caused. If you hardness बढ़ता है, तो foaming निकल जाता है. And now we are going to for BS6, so BS6 के लिए हमको soft water ही चाहिए. So DM water to drinking water is the ideal thing to use.
Okay. Not directly from
the well water, not recommended.
Corporation water is fine.
Corporation is fine.
Okay. So apart from washing chemicals, आप coolants भी बनाते हो.
Yes.
You deal in machining coolants as well.
Yes.
So as you mentioned that. These coolants that you make, these are vegetable oil based.
Right.
आप बता सकते हो कि vegetable oils के फायदे क्या है?
हाँ. See, अभी क्या है? Machining coolant is a very broad subject. कि उसमें तीन types आते हैं. पहला type है is soluble oil. Second is semi-synthetic. Third is synthetic. तो soluble oil में mineral oil ही use होता है.
Okay.
That is given. And वो बरसों से वही चला आ रहा है. In semi-synthetic में जो oil use होता है वो बेसिकली वेजिटेबल ऑयल है. एंड सिंथेटिक में देयर आर ग्लाइकॉल्स, में पॉलीएथिलीन ग्लाइकॉल और पीईजीज, वो सिंथेटिक केमिकल में यूज होता है, व्हिच आर मैन मेड ऑयल्स आई वुड से. बट पॉलीकेम यूजेस वेजिटेबल ऑयल बिकॉज़ वेजिटेबल ऑयल यू बेसिकली यू कांट चैलेंज नेचर. नेचर हैज इट्स ओन वे ऑफ यू नो थिंग्स. तो वहां पे जो लुब्रिसिटी जो एक्सट्रैक्ट होती है वेजिटेबल ऑयल से, that is incomparable with mineral oils.
Okay.
Okay. Second, the supply of vegetable oils will never be exhausted. Because we all humans are consuming. हम वही consume करते हैं, तो वो exhaust नहीं होगा.
So your raw material is
raw material available. And third and the most important thing, India is a country of agriculture. तो जो हमारे country में होता है, जो उगता है, तो वही अगर हम use करें तो ही अपनी कंट्री को फ्यूचर इज ब्राइट.
करेक्ट.
इंस्टेड ऑफ इंपोर्टिंग क्रूड ऑयल फ्रॉम अदर कंट्रीज, उस पे डिपेंडेंसी रखने से दिस इज द बेस्ट थिंग वी कैन डू. सो दीज आर थ्री मेन थिंग्स दैट्स व्हाई वी यूज वेजिटेबल ऑयल.
ओके. एंड व्हेन इट कम्स टू कूलेंट्स, हाउ टू डिसाइड विच कूलेंट टू यूज? आई एम नॉट सेइंग अबाउट ब्रांड्स, बट आई एम श्योर देयर विल बी various within these three types,
right?
Mineral, soluble, yeah. Semi-synthetic,
and synthetic.
And synthetic. Yes. So how to decide for which machining operation, which type of coolant to use?
Right. If it is steel, very hard steel or MS, mild steel, people prefer using soluble oil.
Okay.
Because soluble oil mein bahut jyada lubricity hoti hai, bahut jyada oil content hota hai. So it is excellent for finishing. If you want to go for cast iron machining or forged steel, little softer materials, जहाँ पे जो बर आती है, अभी स्टील में देखेंगे तो बर की एक पूरा एक स्ट्रिप आ रहा है, चिप आ रहा है. इन कास्ट आयरन यू गेट पाउडर. तो ये पाउडर को फ्लश करना है. तो ज्यादा ऑयल कंटेंट अगर बढ़ेगा तो वो पाउडर चिपक जाता है और साइड में मशीन के लगता है. तो फ्लशिंग करने के लिए सेमी सिंथेटिक यूज करते हैं.
ओके.
कि वो फ्लश भी होना चाहिए प्रॉपरली. एंड इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर सम अल्ट्रा फिनिशिंग लाइक बॉल बेयरिंग इंडस्ट्री में है, तो पीपल आर यूजिंग सिंथेटिक ऑयल्स.
ओके.
सिंथेटिक ऑयल्स में एडवांटेज ये है कि पॉली अल्कलीन ग्लाइकॉल्स और पीएच, उनपे एडवांटेज ये कि देयर इज नथिंग लाइक सम लाइफ.
ओह.
वो यू कैन गो फॉर 5 years, 10 years ऑल्सो, क्योंकि वहां पे बैक्टीरिया ग्रो होती नहीं है, स्मेल आता नहीं है. And it's very, but it has its own disadvantages, synthetic may. But because nothing in vegetable oils or in semi-synthetic, we have challenges of these things. So we're putting biocells and other ingredients.
Okay. So synthetic coolant, agar aap use kar rahe ho, to there is a zero chance of
zero.
Bacterial growth?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
A zero chance. Also, we are giving to industries like lens cutting, glass cutting. These people use synthetic oils.
Okay.
So you can keep on using these oils till you get bored or till it finishes or it
okay.
leaks out.
Okay.
But there are zero chances of having any growth. Of
okay. Mr. Deepak is asking, DM or deionized water, which is better?
Demineralized. DM water is better.
Can you just explain? Demineralized. What is the difference between demineralized and deionized?
See, basically. Demineralize is basically removing all the minerals from it. And DI process is also something different than that. But usually it's almost, I would say, from coolant perspective, doesn't matter if it is DM or DI. It just has to be soft water.
Okay.
And the knob, if you want the specs, basically the hardness should be zero.
Okay.
Then the chloride should be less than 5. Fir uske baad, sulfate should be less than 5. So basically that's called a definition of type 3 ASTM DM water.
Type
3? So ASTM, American Standard of Testing Materials, उन्हों define किया है कि DM क्या है, DI क्या है.
Okay.
Yeah.
और soft water क्यों use करना चाहिए? Coolants या washing chemical बनाने के लिए, why soft water needs to be used?
अभी soft water में क्या, if they're using hard water में already there are सॉल्ट्स लाइक क्लोराइड्स, सल्फेट्स, मैग्नीशियम, ये सब प्रेजेंट रहते हैं. तो इट हैपन्स कि अगर आप 400, 500, 600, 700 हार्डनेस का अगर यूज करते हो तो ये सॉल्ट्स जो है वो जो इमल्शन को डिस्टर्ब करते हैं.
ओके.
सो सम इंग्रेडिएंट्स इन द इमल्शन वो इसको हिंदी में बोलते फटना, कूलेंट फट गया, ऐसा एक ये है. तो इट बेसिकली डी इमल्सिफाइज द कूलेंट.
So,
coolant separate and coolant, water separate. Yeah. इसका second disadvantage है कि अगर ज्यादा hardness है तो that will cause rust.
Okay.
Because ये salts जो है वो अपने compound पे deposit होंगे and they will leave a white mark on it.
Pitting
होगा and उसके बाद में brown, like white mark first, फिर उसके बाद brown, which is rust, and then उसके बाद black, which is pitting.
Okay.
So then there is no point in using this. So we recommend to go with soft water.
Okay.
But can I use, कि कोई पूछेगा कि can I use hard water? Yes, we have products for hard water.
अच्छा.
Which can be used.
So आपका formulation अलग होगा.
Yeah, formulation will be अलग. And उसमें we are putting like you know ingredients which will basically remove the hardness
okay.
of the water.
Okay.
But again you know the technology is there.
Hmm.
but it comes with a cost.
Correct.
And we need to know how much we have to put where.
Put in it. So, during my interaction with many customers, there is a, I mean, nobody asks this question directly, but I can see that there is a lack of awareness as to when to change the coolant.
Right.
Or what parameters should be used to decide when I need to change my machining coolant.
Right.
So, general industrial practice is what I have experienced is that it is time based.
Right.
So, once that coolant is filled in the tank, generally it is mandated that mainly by the coolant supplier that change it after 6 months or 1 year.
Right.
Or people decide it based on visual appearance or smell, things like that.
Correct.
But is that the correct way of judging coolant life?
Okay.
So, to repeat in Hindi, what I manage maine pucha hai ki coolant kab change karna hai ye hum kaise decide kar sakte hain kya ye generally industry practice ye hai ki coolant supplier batate hain ki ek 6 mahine mein badal dijiye ya ek saal mein badal dijiye ya fir log uska rang dekh ke change karte hain ya fir uski agar badbu aani shuru ho jaye to चेंज करते हैं लेकिन कुछ ऐसे पैरामीटर्स हैं टू डिसाइड और टू हम डिसाइड कर सकते हैं कि अभी कूलेंट चेंज करना चाहिए
right. अभी कैसे होता है कि व्हेन वी स्टार्ट कूलेंट को यूज करते हैं हम तो पहले 2-3 मंथ्स एवरीथिंग इज वेरी स्वीट वो सब अच्छा ही चलता है फिर बाद में उसमें कंटामिनेशन आना चालू होता है कंटामिनेशन इज कि जो इनकमिंग कंपोनेंट्स है वो कंपोनेंट्स के ऊपर जो ऑयल है या जो भी है वो दैट स्टार्ट्स टू प्ले अ रोल उसके बाद में वाटर क्वालिटी चेंजेस दो पीपल से कि वी आर यूजिंग डीएम वाटर या रॉ वाटर व्हाटएवर दे यूजिंग दैट क्वालिटी कीप्स ऑन चेंजिंग सो इफ यू सी कि कूलेंट ये जो है उसमें 3-5% ही कॉन्सेंट्रेट है बाकी 95-97% इज वाटर सो वाटर इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट
करेक्ट
Coolant will play, but coolant plays a 5% part.
So,
ये 95% है water का part है. And water keeps changing. Water उसका अगर rainy season में थोड़ा पानी अलग आता है, summer में अलग आता है. Because the hardness and everything is different. But वो combat करने के लिए additives उसमें डले हुए हैं. तो what we tell our customers कि regular oil removal, cleaning, then concentration should always be maintained. फिर pH value, RA value, RA value is reserve alkalinity. Reserve alkalinity is a value जो आपको बताती है कि coolant की ताकत कितनी है, कितनी ताकत रह गई coolant में. RI जो है refractive index, that is just telling कितना coolant है. और RA बताती है वो जो कितना coolant है उसकी ताकत कितनी है. ये भी monitor करते हैं. उसके बाद में sulfates, chlorides कितने हैं coolant में, वो हम monitor करते हैं. बर कितनी है कई लोग वो बर निकालते ही नहीं है वो बर वही पड़ी रहती है सो वो मेटल अगर कूलर में वो मेटल के चिप्स भीगे पड़े हुए है वो वीक्स टुगेदर तो वो कुछ तो करेंगे उसके साथ ऐसा नहीं कि वो अंदर है तो उसका रिमूवल इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट तो इट्स गिव अ सिंपल एग्जांपल कूलेंट मैनेजमेंट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कूलेंट केमिकल कूलेंट मैनेजमेंट जो बोलते हैं वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इट इज व्हाट आई फील इज जस्ट लाइक अ स्मॉल चाइल्ड कि कोई छोटा बच्चा है और उसको हमको डायपर चेंज करना पड़ता है एक ही डायपर लगा दिया उसको और ऐसा नहीं होगा यू टू चेंज तो वैसा कूलेंट का है बिकॉज देयर आर मेनी अदर फैक्टर्स प्लेइंग इन तो यू हैव टू मॉनिटर दैट उसका कॉन्सेंट्रेशन लिखना है एवरी डे फिल्ट्रेशन हुआ है क्या नहीं दिस आवर वी कैन वी डू इट टू आवर कस्टमर्स बट कस्टमर्स ऑल्सो हैव टू सपोर्ट इन दिस
करेक्ट
कि दे हैव टू गिव अस फ्रीडम फॉर दिस या फिल्ट्रेशन करना है ऑयल रिमूवल करना है ये सब करना पड़ता है उसमें
ओके
देन द लाइफ कैन गो टू 1 ईयर 2 ईयर 3 ईयर सेमी सिंथेटिक मे बी व्हिच वी हैव गिवन इन सेंट्रलाइज्ड टैंक्स
ओ
सो या
सो यू मेंशनड पीएच यू मेंशनड आरए आरआई
राइट
सो आई नो दैट दीस वैल्यूज कैन वी कैन चेक इन द लैब
राइट
बट ऑन अ डे टू डे बेसिस हाउ कैन पीपल मेजर दिस और चेक दिस
नाउ द गुड थिंग इज देयर आर स्मॉल किट्स अवेलेबल basically RI is checked by a refractive meter For all the salts content, there is a small kits which are available in the market, which they can check on their own. Array value, it can be done by the iteration method. Agar nahi hai, toh we give that service to our customers. And for bacteria sites, there are small strips are available to check the bacteria content. That also customers or people can check that. So, ye total and iska record hona bahut zaruri hai. It's very very important to have record. क्योंकि ये रिकॉर्ड लगाने से इट इज वी थिंक दैट वी आर बेसिकली हैविंग गुड चैलेंज.
आई एम सॉरी देयर वाज अ बिट ऑफ अ टेक्निकल ग्लिच बट वी आर बैक नाउ.
सो जस्ट आई वाज सेइंग इज लाइक दीस पैरामीटर्स हैव टू बी चेक्ड एवरी डे एंड रिकॉर्डेड एंड हैव टू बी प्लॉटेड ऑन अ ग्राफ एंड देन वी गेट टू नो व्हाट काइंड ऑफ ट्रेंड इज गोइंग ऑन क्या ट्रेंड चल रहा है कस्टमर के पास. पर इसके लिए यू नो we need a studious approach.
Correct.
तो आप कस्टमर को बता सकेंगे क्या हो रहा है क्या चल रहा है. They also get impressed.
Correct. So it's like going to a doctor.
Correct.
अगर डॉक्टर को के पास जाने से पहले आपके पास रिकॉर्ड होगा कि कितना टेम्परेचर था क्या फील हो रहा है अगर ये सब बताएंगे तो डॉक्टर विल बी एबल टू गिव यू अ बेटर डायग्नोसिस.
Exactly. Exactly.
Correct. That's a very good point.
Yeah.
So apart from checking these parameters, is there any basic care or basic steps that, or rather I would say, are there any habits that manufacturers can implement in their organization to maintain these chemicals or coolants properly?
Kaise hota hai ki in our journey for this coolant, long life coolant, और नो पीपल वांट इटरनल लाइफ कूलेंट कि कूलेंट डाला तो कभी चेंज ही नहीं करना है. दैट इज पॉसिबल बट इट हैज टू बी फ्रॉम बोथ साइड्स फ्रॉम अ केमिकल मैन्युफैक्चरर लुब्रिकेंट एंड अ कस्टमर साइड. तो दीज पैरामीटर्स हैव टू बी चेक दैट इज नंबर वन एंड ऑल दीज पैरामीटर्स आर इम्पॉर्टेंट बिकॉज वॉट हैपन्स इज लाइक एज द सीजन चेंजेस कि अगर विंटर से हम समर जाते हैं समर से हम वी गो टू रेनी सीजन तो एनी सीजन आता है तो रस्टिंग इश्यूज चालू होते हैं. तो पीपल से क्या ये बैच खराब है क्या दिस इज नॉट गुड बट बिकॉज ऑफ द एनवायरमेंटल चेंजेस सी द कूलेंट इज 3-5% 95 इज वाटर एंड अगेन ऑन टॉप ऑफ दैट 100 देयर इज एनवायरमेंटल चेंजेस. सो समवेयर इट इज रेनिंग अ लॉट समवेयर पीपल आर कीपिंग इट आउटसाइड तो ये बहुत सारे चेंजेस आते हैं एंड अनफॉर्चुनेटली एवरीथिंग कम्स डाउन टू द कूलेंट विच इज 3% और 5% ओनली फॉर टैंक में से. सो to combat that there is no perfect coolant. Even if you go 400 rupees liter of coolant or you go to 200 rupees of coolant, there are additives which people try to put in if required. If there is some pH drop issue, then there is a additive to boost the pH. If there is some kind of smell issue because of something else, so biocides are available which we supply. So ye additives kabhi kabhi dalne padte hain. So I have not seen any company saying that there are no additives and we are going straight.
And so you mentioned about these concentrations.
Yes.
ये हम कैसे पता कर सकते हैं कि हमको 3% coolant concentration चाहिए या 5% चाहिए या 7% चाहिए?
Yes. वो भी क्या होता है? Decide on basically tool life also.
Okay.
कि if customer says कि I want excellent tool life and that component is very fine thinness चाहिए. फिनिश अच्छा चाहिए देन वी गो टू अ हायर कंसंट्रेशन 6-8% भी जाते हैं.
व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम?
मैक्सिमम सी नाउ आई विल जस्ट कम टू दैट.
सो
6-7 दिस इज फॉर नॉर्मल मशीनिंग. नाउ इफ यू आर डूइंग ग्राइंडिंग तो 2-3% इज मोर देन सफिशिएंट बिकॉज़ इन ग्राइंडिंग लुब्रिसिटी इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. ग्राइंडिंग ऑपरेशन में लुब्रिसिटी की जरूरत बहुत कम है.
फ्लशिंग चाहिए.
एक्शन चाहिए वो बर फ्लश होनी चाहिए तो 2-3% बहुत हो गया. अगर टोटल बोरिंग है डीप ड्रिल है so you have to go with 10%.
Okay.
Abhi now in Polychem we have successfully replaced operations jaise broaching ya gear hobbing jahan pe neat oil use hota hai wahan pe hum coolant de rahe
hain.
Okay. So neat oil is costing 100 rupees for example. So our is basically with dilution it costs 25-30 rupees.
Wow.
That's the biggest advantage for people in cost and with 20-25% of coolant used for broaching ya hobbing the life is also effective and fantastic.
Correct.
For the hob or the this thing.
So the obviously the machining operation is going to decide what concentration of coolant is to be used.
Yes.
But is there any sort of thumb rule that people can use?
3-5% okay. is what people general
that is general machine.
Wo karna hai. But the thing comes is now in our muscle cool series of coolants, basically we are in a technology called inverse solubility. Inverse solubility is ki bahut hamare customers ne bhi dekha hai ki jaise jaise machining hota hai to the refractive index concentration badhte jata hai
okay
to log bahut hum call aate ki concentration badh kaise raha hai
hmm.
to what people do ki our concentration agar 5 ka 6 hota hai 6 ka 7 hota hai 7 ka 8 hota hai because our jo vegetable oil esters dale hue hai usme dale hue hai uska evaporation point bahut high hai तो जब इवेपोरेशन होता है तब ओनली द वाटर इवेपोरेट्स एंड द कूलेंट कंसंट्रेशन
कीप्स ऑन इट
तो सेकंड उसका ये आता है कि अरे बहुत बढ़िया कूलेंट है 7 8 तक पहुंच गया अभी मैं कूलेंट डालता ही नहीं हूं मैं सिर्फ पानी डालूंगा तो वी टेल देम ऐसा नहीं करना है यू हैव टू कीप ऑन एडिंग कूलेंट आप अगर 2% ड्रॉप अप कर रहे हो 1.5 से कीजिए पर जस्ट पानी नहीं डालना है उसमें क्योंकि क्या होता है कि एक बार वो 8 तक जाता है एंड उसके बाद में फटाक से 3 तक आता है बिकॉज़ लॉट ऑफ पानी एंड देन रस्टिंग इश्यूज एंड ऑल दिस इश्यूज स्टार्ट होते हैं तो यू ऑलवेज हैव टू प्रिपेयर अ टैंक जहां पे वो 3-2% का डाइल्यूटेड कूलेंट रेडी होना चाहिए सो इन फर्स्ट सेकंड थर्ड एनी शिफ्ट है ऑपरेटर्स वो डालेंगे
ओके
आई स्ट्रिक्टली टेल पीपल टू अवॉइड कि पानी डालो फिर कूलेंट डालो फिर यू नो ऐसा नहीं मिक्स इट वेल और वो डालिए उसमें
हां सो दैट इज अ वेरी गुड पॉइंट आई मीन जनरली पीपल टॉप अप these coolants every day.
Right.
ये टॉप अप मशीन में रोज करना पड़ता है या फिर एक जैसे ही लेवल नीचे चली जाती है वैसे करना पड़ता है लेकिन वो टॉप अप करने से पहले जो स्टेप है कि कूलेंट प्रिपरेशन जनरली ये यानी हैपेजर्डली की छोटे कंपनीज में तो मैंने देखा है कि लिटरली लोग पानी लेते हैं और उसमें कुछ ऑयल डालते हैं What is the ideal method of making coolant?
See, अभी in general industry हम ऐसा नहीं बोलेंगे कि कुछ mixer लाओ ये लाओ, but in a fresh clean tank, tank should be clean. उसमें पानी डालिए, 5% या 2% से अपना coolant डालिए and keep it ready.
Okay.
Now लोगों को लगता है कि सिर्फ rust का problem एक ही है, तो rust का सिर्फ नहीं है problem. The problem is basically there are other ingredients also. Other ingredients माने there are रस्ट प्रिवेंटिव्स है फिर उसमें बायोसाइड्स है फंगीसाइड्स है पीएच बूस्टर्स है वो सारे उसमें जाते हैं तो जस्ट डोंट डिस्काउंट कि मेरा कॉन्सेंट्रेशन बढ़ रहा है तो मैं सिर्फ पानी डालूंगा फिर वो सिनर्जी पूरी खराब हो जाती है पर बाद में आप कितना भी कूलेंट डालिए टू कम टू दैट नॉर्मल स्टेज इट टेक्स टाइम
ओके
तो एक दफा मेरा रस्टिंग चालू हो गया अरे मेरा आरआई ड्रॉप हो गया तो फटाक से 10 लीटर डाल दिया नो ये 2% तो ही टॉप अप करना ही पड़ेगा फॉर अदर कॉम्पोनेंट्स टू गो
There is a question from Mr. Narendra Kumar.
Yeah.
Is there common coolant recommended for both stainless steel and aluminium material for machining of component with an 1 to 5 micron? I think that was the next question that we were going to discuss.
Yes.
Multi-metal machining.
Abhi kya ho raha hai ki ek hi CNC machine mein ya VMC machine mein people want to machine all components. So cast iron, steel, brass, bronze, कॉपर सब करना है सो द मल्टी मेटल और एल्यूमिनियम मेनली एल्यूमिनियम एंड एल्यूमिनियम फॉर लाइट वेट तो एल्यूमिनियम के लिए पहले अलग कूलर आता था एंड फॉर कास्ट एंड स्टील के लिए अलग था पर अभी इन पॉलीकेम वी हैव कॉमन कूलेंट विच इज अ मल्टी मेटल
ओके
तो मल्टी मेटल मीन्स इन वन मशीन यू कैन मशीन स्टेनलेस स्टील एल्यूमिनियम ब्रास कॉपर एवरीथिंग कैन बी मशीन और ये स्पेशल क्यों है बिकॉज इसमें से वी वॉन्ट टू टेक केयर कि जो एल्यूमिनियम ब्रास कॉपर उसमें स्टेनिंग ना हो एंड जब ये ब्रास और ब्रॉन्ज आता है तो ब्रॉन्ज की ये एक फितरत होती है कि वो कूलेंट का पीएच ड्रॉप करे तो 9.5 से 8 तक जाता है बड़ा कूलेंट ऐसे स्टेबल है कि जिसमें से हमको स्टेबल मशीनिंग के लिए लगता है सो यस वी हैव मल्टी मेटल मशीनिंग कूलेंट्स
ओके एंड ऑब्वियसली सो Does this type of coolant, is it like for certain types of combinations of metals or I mean, they can
common. They can be common.
It can be anything. Yes, bronze with yes. stainless steel with yes. aluminium, anything. Yes. Okay.
But we in Polychem, what we do is we have a questionnaire. So we go with a methodological approach. If you go into a customer, first there is a 10 questions which we ask the customer. What are you machining? What is the micron finish you want? How much you expect? What you expect out of the coolant? Or what is the life you are getting now? And any challenges? If you are shifting to us, then some challenge will happen, so you shift to it. Or maybe cost. There is a problem in the cost. So we take this down.
Okay.
So I say that to all, basically you have to focus on three things. One is what the customer wants. Okay. Then want to apne puri kar li. Fir uske baad mein hai what the customer desires. And the third thing is unmet needs of customer. Unmet need aise hote hai kuch bhi karo. Free bhi do, fir bhi I'm not happy. Top product free mein, fir bhi I'm not happy. Kyun? To kuch to aise unmet need hogi. And this is for everyone.
Correct.
For us also. To wo unmet need kya hai? Free to not, definitely people not give. बट वो अनमेट नीड जो है कस्टमर की वो आप ढूंढो एंड वहां पे वर्क करो. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ पुशिंग अ प्रोडक्ट आई टेल ऑल माय पीपल इन द कंपनी और माय सेल्स टीम डू नॉट पुश अ प्रोडक्ट फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड द प्रॉब्लम व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम व्हाट दे आर लुकिंग फॉर एंड देन गिव अ सॉल्यूशन.
करेक्ट.
सो Polychem इज नाउ नोन इन द मार्केट एज अ सॉल्यूशन प्रोवाइडर रादर देन अ सेलर.
करेक्ट.
तो सेलिंग के लिए वी कैन यू नो सेल चिप्स एंड सॉस एंड ये भी सेल करते हैं पर हमको सॉल्यूशन देना है बिकॉज़ वी आर इन अ टेक्निकल इंडस्ट्री. तो डू नॉट गो एंड स्टार्ट रैबलिंग अबाउट मेरे पास ये है वो है वो है कुछ तो लो. नो
पीपल डोंट वांट कूलेंट दे वांट अ सॉल्यूशन.
तो वो सॉल्यूशन कुछ भी होगा एंड एज Polychem हैज अ वाइड वैरायटी ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स लाइक वॉशिंग केमिकल्स देन मशीनिंग कूलेंट्स देन रस्ट प्रिवेंटिव्स देन टेलर मेड सॉल्यूशंस इवन वी गिव हैंड वॉश वी गिव फ्लोर क्लीनर्स वी गिव पाउडर्ड hand wash packets.
Okay.
So once we go in, people will, you know, think of the entire company and how we can serve them.
There is a question from Mr. Deepak. Can multi-machine coolant be used in magnesium like AM60 or AZ91D?
Yes. Now this is a very good question. Ki magnesium, jo hai, what happens is this magnesium alloy. So when we machine, so for example, day one, the hardness use DM water, for example. So magnesium, agar wo component mein hai, that mein, so day one, the hardness is zero, you start with it. Day two, day first week, jane do, second week, mein, the hardness of that coolant becomes 400.
Oh.
And it creeps to 1000 also. As the magnesium comes in the coolant, it starts to de-emulsify the coolant.
Okay.
And then you get totally the coolant kharab ho jata 10-15 din mein kharab ho jata you have to throw it out. So there are special formulation which we have par ye bahut 1 in 100 case hoti hai ki magnesium is called magnesium leaching.
Okay.
So wo jo phenomena hai uske liye special coolant hai it comes in synthetic category and that will solve the issue.
Okay. There is another question from Mr. Jimit Shah. Cast iron how much pH percentage to be maintained?
9 to 9.5.
Okay, it's a blanket.
Blanket, yes.
Okay. So, going ahead, like there is a way of discarding washing chemicals.
Yes.
Is there any ideal way of, or is it a different way of discarding coolants?
See, exactly similar as washing chemicals. What we do is, if a coolant life is over, we tell the customers to remove the coolant, filter it completely, put some additional additives and put it back.
Okay.
And keep on using it.
Okay. So people can use the
yes, yes.
old coolant.
Old coolant, yes. If you they say ki nahi humko fekna hi nahi hai. To nikal ke rakhiye, apna fresh coolant daliye aur beech beech mein top up kijiye. Why we are doing this? Because isse kya hoga ki advantage is the customer does not have to throw the coolant away.
Correct.
And if you want to throw to ETP aa gaya, ye sab aa gaya. Okay, ekdam worst coolant ho gaya hai, pura black ho gaya hai and there is no way I can retrieve it, then you have to throw it away. There is no choice. But try to keep on using it.
Yeah. I think, I mean, we were working on that
correct.
Problem exactly. in one of the companies.
Correct, exactly.
We came very close to recovering the coolant
correct.
Also.
Correct, correct.
Unfortunately, due to lockdown, it couldn't, the project
exactly.
could not be executed.
Correct. But that is a very good way which we have done, and that should be implemented by all.
Yeah. To tell you, I mean, there are various other companies which have contacted us to give that solution.
Okay.
Hopefully, if the lockdown conditions are not this restrictive, then we can, in very near future, we will be able to have one
Correct.
Installation.
And you should make a video and then circulate to everyone.
Yeah, yeah.
That helps.
There is a question, will salt or sugar content in water damage the coolant?
Yes. Definitely.
So I have, mujhe pata hai ki salts hote hain, lekin sugar bhi hota hai?
To be honest, we have not tried sugar, to be honest. So salt definitely will kill it, but sugar ka I don't have a clue.
So I think that is, I mean, we covered most of the
yes.
points in coolants.
Yes.
So now you also touched upon an important point where you mentioned you have replaced or you can replace traditionally neat oil applications like
yes.
honing, broaching,
yes.
Even honing. I mean,
yes.
I was surprised to know that even honing you can do with water-based
yes.
coolants.
Yes. See, what happened? Neat oil has tremendous lubricity because it is 100% neat oil and it has different ingredients, say phosphorus, sulfur, and many ingredients are there, but we have designed in water-based coolants all these are called EP additives, extreme pressure additives, or AW called antivirus additives. So the whole thought process is like we are having or making water soluble sulfur. So
okay.
these sulfur are basically only neat oil soluble, but we have water soluble sulfur technology, so these can be put in the coolant.
Okay.
And it is achievable. Or we are using some ingredients which are proprietary to us and we are making it ourselves, which basically increases the tool life and gives a fantastic finish to the components.
Okay.
Only care has to be taken from the customer side is that, say, a neat oil machine is designed to pump oil.
Hmm.
So the O-rings, the seals, the pump are all for oil compatible or they are self-lubricating. So in the same system, if you start putting a water-based coolant like with 20%, then those O-rings and the pumps should not get damaged.
Okay.
So that confirmation has to be taken before going for a trial for honing or these things.
Okay.
Or they have to put a different water pump.
Correct.
For that pH.
Yeah.
The neat oil has no pHs, but this is 9.5.
Okay.
That should damage the other machine components.
Okay. There is a question. What should be flow rate and pressure so that micro emulsion does not split?
Our flow rate and pressure will not split the coolant.
Correct.
Basically, that is irrespective of that.
I think it is the bacteria which will...
Bacteria which will split. So, pressure and will not split the coolant at all. It will mix it basically more.
Correct.
Yeah.
And basically, flow and pressure is what the machine requires.
Yes.
It is not the requirement of the coolant.
No, not at all. Not at all.
Do you have any competition of cheaper substitutes from China?
China is a big subject, my friends.
Especially these days.
Especially these days. Just to talk about China, they have a total different mentality. Okay? And we think that China is cheaper. Made in China is equal to cheaper class. But in China, if you go, I visited 6 times, there is one segment which is made in China, toys and all these things. But there is second segment they are catering to is for the European and American countries, which are superior products. And in Chinese, they have that mentality of bulk and abundance manufacturing. They don't have the POs, they don't have the orders. But 6 months, they will keep on 24 hours, they'll be making the product. So
okay.
their per piece cost is very, very less.
Hmm.
So if they're selling it less, that doesn't mean it's cheap.
Correct.
They can compete for a bearing industry and say SK or some other, our Indian company is going to make a bearing for say 100 rupees. China will give the same bearing at 20 rupees.
Wow.
Okay, maybe the quality must be 19-20, aisa nahi ki like going to be 100%, but they can give because of their mentality and the government support given to them, they can make a cheaper product.
Okay.
So, till now, in our industry, Chinese have not entered to compete.
At least in the Indian market.
In Indian market. They will or they don't, I don't know, but they have not.
Okay. So, apart from neat oil replacing with water-based, you also make these radiator coolants.
Yes.
And I mean, you suggest on your website that why water should be used and not glycol based should be used. I mean, what is the difference between water and glycol? Yes.
See, in radiator coolant, when we say maybe for passenger vehicles or commercial vehicles, the trend is 50-50 or 60-40. 50-50 means 50% is glycol, rest is water and additives. 60-40 is 60% is glycol and less 40 is water and additives. Now, glycol is basically extremely hazardous.
Mm.
Okay, you cannot treat a monoethylene glycol ETP. You cannot throw that in, you know, anywhere. Okay, so that is a big pain and very difficult to treat. Now, glycol is used in radiator coolant for only two things. One is a freezing point. It gives a lower freezing point. Say a 50-50 coolant, the freezing point may be minus 32, minus 35 degrees Celsius. And second advantage is it elevates the boiling point of the radiator coolant. Now, boiling point of water based is 100, but if you put 50-50 glycol, the boiling point is 110.
Okay.
So it gives a boiling point protection.
Okay. Okay.
Now, in this scenario, in India, if you are, if the temperature we know is not going to go below zero, our try is for engine testing why we have to use a glycol.
Mm.
Okay, boiling point protection, yes, we get that. But if you can use a water-based coolant, and mainly coolants are used for only two things. One is cooling, because that's why they are called coolants. And the most, the excellent coolant in the world is water.
Okay.
Water does the cooling part, which is there anyways. Yeah. And second is rust formation.
Mm.
That coolant, water-based coolant, should protect the components.
Internal
components. It is steel, cast iron, brass, copper, solder, and aluminium.
Okay.
These are the components which the coolant has to protect.
Okay.
So these are two things. So cooling is done by water, and rust protection is given by the technology people are putting in. And if antifreeze is not required, and if the temperature of engine testing is not going to go below above 80, there is no need of
glycol. Okay.
And why create waste?
Correct. So, I mean, glycol is a hazardous chemical.
It's hazardous, yes.
Okay.
So it's better not to use. Okay, if you're exporting somewhere, then yes, you can flush with glycol based coolant and then give it.
Okay. So this chemical, if I understand correctly, it is for when radiators are tested.
Yes.
It is not for using in the radiator.
For using in radiator, also if you use water based, it will evaporate more.
Hmm.
So just to get a boiling point incremental, you can use glycols about 40-50% minimum.
Okay.
But again, that depends. That will also change in coming days.
Okay.
So we need, because there are no antifreeze properties not required.
Correct.
And if there is a glycol coolant and a non-glycol coolant, the difference is not big, but the technology of corrosion protection is most important.
Okay. And when it comes to BS6 norms, both are fine.
Both are fine, yes.
Okay.
Now we are into also radiator coolant technology for EV, for electric vehicles. So, but because of that, batteries getting heated up, we have a coolant for that. But right now the main thing is that the radiators or engine coolant system was made up of copper before.
Mm.
Now it is aluminium.
Okay.
So all our focus and work has been on aluminium more. So we are, our coolants are basically approved by Cummins. They are approved by ARAI, so all the certifications are with us. And mainly aluminum heat rejection or glassware corrosion are the main points to be considered for a coolant, which we all surpass. Again, engine manufacturers, does a testing with our coolant, then he exports it somewhere. It takes 3 months to go, 3 months in the warehouse, and then to the customer. So 6 months to 8 months. It should not rust inside.
Hmm.
So that we have taken care of.
Okay.
By doing simulation in engine, like putting in the engine and keeping it for a year.
Okay.
And then opening it up and seeing if it is not rusted. So that ASTM test is there, which we have already passed.
Acha. And so there is one question. Why the walls of machine get red while machining cast iron in CNC or VMC? What's the issue?
Red meaning, if you were saying rusty,
I've mainly seen people doing cast iron machining.
Yeah.
The coolant itself, the color becomes red or reddish.
That is the traditional. If you the coolant on the top is reddish, and if you put your finger and if it is white, then that red thing is basically two things. One is the tramp oil leakage, which is coming, and that tramp oil gets mixed in the coolant. So the machining coolant should have a property that it will not emulsify the tramp oil. It should reject the tramp oil. If a coolant is emulsifying, वो अंदर ले रहा है अगर tramp oil को, तो वही tramp oil जाके पूरे machining के ऊपर जाएगा और वो लाल हो जाएगा. So that's why filtration is very important to remove. वो oil remove करना चाहिए.
Correct.
So I think that's the answer for that.
I think filtration will remove the cast iron burr or cast iron powder, and an oil separator will remove the tramp oil on top of it, and both will solve probably this problem.
Exactly. And coolant mein property honi chahiye ki wo tramp oil ko andar na le, reject kare.
Correct.
Because wo part and parcel formulation ka nahi hai. Agar wahi leta raha wo, to coolant kharab ho jayega.
Correct. You mentioned about one of your formulation or solutions for electric vehicles.
Yes.
So there is, I am very interested. It is a topic of my interest, electric vehicles. Yes. Is there any, so what I have read is in the car itself, the number of components is going to go down in electric vehicles. Some of the fluids that we use inside the car, those obviously will get reduced. But do you see a trend of reduction in use of fluids because of?
IC engines, internal combustion engines now are right now going on, and EV has picked up. Again, I say change is the only constant. So we have to adapt to the new changes. But if you see the European and American market, right now they are very much advanced. But still, if you see the ratio of EV, वहां पे देखेंगे तो अभी वो 6-7% ही है.
Correct.
इतने एडवांस में, और हमारे यहाँ 1-2% भी नहीं है. तो मे बी इन नेक्स्ट 20 इयर्स हमारा 6-7% तक जाएगा. तो बाकी तो 90-92% इज आईसी इंजन्स है. सो वी आर ऑल गुड, आई होप सो.
सो आई थिंक 10-20 इयर्स नो. ओके,
बिकॉज़ फॉर इन इंडिया वी शुड हैव दैट इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर.
करेक्ट.
इलेक्ट्रिसिटी स्टोरेज, ईज ऑफ getting the electricity.
Correct. So regarding Polychem, before this our session started, you were mentioning that there are some initiatives that you are taking internally to improve your established systems.
Correct.
So can you just elaborate on them?
I'm very proud to tell that in Polychem, as me and my wife were in US for so many years, we are very proud that all the things which we have learned there, and if you come to visit our company, you will see that things run on system. And the first thing, the most precious thing in Polychem, like I would say, if you ask me what is the most precious thing or what I like about Polychem, is my people. So our people are our strength, and from all departments, because they make Polychem proud. So in Polychem there is no I, it's all we in Polychem. And so basically we're implementing new systems like SAP. Then we are having a program called DSI, that is called Daily Small Improvements, where everyone participates. Every person coming to work should do a new improvement, something very small. It's okay, but a small improvement makes go a long way.
Correct.
So we have this DSI culture or Daily Small Improvements, which right from operators to the top management, everybody does that DSIs. Then in this lockdown period, we have trained our people to do a CAPA, like corrective action, preventive actions. Then we are doing 5S, we have reached almost 4S, so we're doing 5S every day. Then we are doing training. See, I will tell you one story, that this Ford GM Chrysler, there was a consultant, and he was, you know, all worried, not worried that, how come this Toyota is number one? Like rain or shine, Toyota is number one. So we met the chairman of Toyota, and we went to Japan and said, what do you guys do that we are not doing? And only one word the chairman said was training.
Oh.
And when we say training, training whom? Training people. Because people are the assets. So from that, we have started from last 2 years, a tremendous amount of training on people. Then let it be an operators, let it be middle management, let it be myself. Everybody has to get trained.
Correct.
And training. It has to be a way of life. So we have a special trainer, special training room where continuously people are getting trained. For example, we have courses on waste management, types of wastes. Then we are doing on etiquettes for salespeople, how to talk, how to understand. Then we do mocking basically. That I'm the customer and we do this play.
And role play.
Role plays we do. So these things are excellent for people. And when people get engaged, then and because the whole goal is to go world class.
Correct.
If you want to be world class, we have to be all getting trained. Nobody in the world is that I'm perfect and I have all the training in the world. We have to keep on doing it. So that is very important. So there are many, many different activities we do in Polychem. I wish that you guys can visit us and see and give us more suggestions.
Definitely.
Then all the 5S activities are posted. Also, if you see for employee morale and boost, we are having, we're putting songs in the company for 8 hours. So people have this notion of, working and they feel at home. So
okay.
All these things have to be done.
So for all the audience, I would like to mention that you can post your questions now if you have any. We are almost at the end of the session, so we can continue till 4:30, and if you have any questions, please let us know. So are there any, can we expect some new products coming out from Polychem in the near future?
Yes, the latest product which we are working with an OEM is DPF, that's called diesel particulate filter cleaning.
Okay.
So now in BS6, what they have done is they have put these catalytic converters. So these will be, after a year or so or 1 lakh kilometers, 2 lakh, they'll be all fused or totally filled with nitrogen dioxide or soot. And that has to be cleaned. So we have, formulated a product and already supplying to the OEMs to clean these DPFs. Because that will be coming now, after it's been a year now. And so these product will have a great demand. Second is, if we do tailor-made products based on customers' requirements, say wire drying coolants, wire drying powders, or rust preventives. So all innovation comes from customers.
Customers' needs, correct.
What customers' unmet needs are, we have to understand, convert to desires, and then desires to wants.
Wow.
And then only we get innovation and products.
Correct.
So there are many products which we are working on.
So there is a question. Do you have any special initiatives in place for environmental protection?
Yes. Basically, for environmental protection, we are basically, this pollution control certification is there. But just awareness programs that we get consultants or speakers from outside and train the people on various subjects about what is wrong, what is right. So that initiatives we are taking. Again, we had one product basically to absorb oil on the shop floors.
Okay.
So we had, it is made from the moss.
Oh.
Which, so usko, wo jo green color ka aata hai na moss. Usme se banaya hua hai product ho, that absorbs oil.
Okay.
And that, so we wo bahut humne Dubai ko export bhi kiya product ko. And after that, this moss will have all the oil
in it.
तो लोगों ने बोला अब इसका करना क्या है तो यू कैन पुट इन फर्नेस तो ये जस्ट फॉर दिस वी हैव टेकन दिस मॉस एंड गिविंग इट टू विलेजेस यहां पे वो अपने चूल्हे में डाल सकते हैं
ओके
इट गिव्स अ मोर कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू
टू
दैट थिंग वैसे अलग अलग प्रोडक्ट्स बहुत है तो एनी चैलेंजेस प्रॉब्लम्स कस्टमर के पास है तो वी आर हियर टू हेल्प
ओके मिस्टर नरेंद्र कुमार इज आस्किंग फॉर कैटलॉग ऑफ वेरियस प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ पॉलीकेम
यस ऑन द वेबसाइट इफ यू गो टू polychem.co.in you'll find all the products. And then if you want anything special, you can let us know. We're happy to help.
I'll just mention the...
CHA.
Oh.
Yeah, talking about DPF.
Talking about DPF, is the product cleans the pores of the filter, as the filter is 1 micron absolute?
Yes, yes, it does.
Okay.
It has to be in an ultrasonic machine, and it is designed to clean that.
Okay. Yes. And what happens to this fluid or this?
This fluid has to be thrown out.
Achha, you have to discard.
Yes. Then we are just judging after how many DPF you have to throw.
Okay.
It will not depend on time and month, but it will depend on number of DPFs cleaned.
Achha. And I mean, since this is going to be installed, or this DPF is sort of a BS6
yes.
Compliance thing, do the OEMs will have such DPF cleaning systems in with their service centers?
Yes.
Or I mean,
with the dealers.
Okay.
The set will be given to them.
Okay.
So they will basically take out one DPF, put a new one, and clean
this. And clean this one. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Does it improve the soot holding capacity? I think it is
yes.
The filter.
Yes, it does.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, how much, I don't know. The OEM has to decide.
Yeah.
But it does change the whole setup.
What would you like to say about bio-based coolants and products?
Yes, bio-based coolants are what we are doing, where we are using esters, vegetable oil esters, from use cover. So that is now the future demand for that. And the dependence on crude oil or mineral oil will start to go down, or has to go down.
Mm.
And everybody, Joby, the users, the manufacturers, has to think about how we can be on the global map, how India can be on the global map. That is extremely important. If everybody thinks, then only we are going to grow.
Correct.
We just cannot keep on blaming the government and the policies. Wo to hai hi, wo sab log kar hi rahe hain. But what we can contribute to the country is more important at our level.
Correct.
I'm not saying at a very high level, but at our level, apna contribution kya hai? That is more important than what the government is doing.
Correct.
They are doing their part, we should do our part.
That is, I mean, what they do is not in our control
anyways.
Correct,
correct. So what we do is in our control.
So bio-based coolants is basically using environmentally friendly
and made in India ingredients
to make the coolant.
To make any product.
Okay. So now this is a question generally as you
yeah.
as a businessman, not as a chemical engineer.
Yeah.
What are some of the challenges you face while doing this business?
Now, being an MSME, there are challenges. See, if you again start comparing us with China or with the European countries, yes, we have to. We have a lot to do, but at least, you know, challenges in the term, like financial challenges, bank, electricity, water, these are like the basic things which are there. But I can see an improvement in last 5 years or 6 years.
Correct.
But things are improving, definitely.
Yeah.
Before it was like, yeah, aaj to light nahi hai, ye nahi hai, wo
correct.
Nahi hai.
Especially since we are almost in the same area.
Yeah.
I can see the difference
yes.
as well. I mean,
yes.
electricity. The situation is much improved.
Correct. The roads are getting improved.
Yeah.
The roads first in our area was, you know, tar,
horrible.
They have gone cement.
Yeah.
All over the country. So improvements are happening. So the golden time or golden period of India will come. But we have to have patience.
Correct.
That's the only thing. And always think what we can do. Everybody thinks that what they can do for the country and not the reverse, that what country can do for them. Then I think we are in a win-win situation.
Correct.
All the government people, all the, you know, officers, they are here to support. We have to just, you know, help each other.
Correct.
That's the only thing.
And Mr. Deepak is asking, does it meet ROHS and REACH specs? I don't know what.
Yeah, REACH specs and ROHS, we have not, you know, for some products or the customers who are want, we can get that done. But because the formulations are being used, per the REACH specs, all the ingredients are used, but we have not got the REACH certification for a particular product.
Can you just elaborate what these specs are?
REACH and ROHS have to be do with environmental conditions or environmental safety and hazardous chemicals. So we don't anyways use it, but some European EU unions, they ask you go and comply
okay.
for that. So we have to get a certificate from them by disclosing what you're using.
Okay. So in your products, does it like, if I go and buy any food products in the market, there is a list of ingredients mentioned.
Yes.
So
yes.
Similar is the case with you?
In MSDS, safety data sheet we mentioned.
Okay.
Along with the CAS number.
Okay.
Which user can go and see.
Okay.
That is all declared. That is mandatory.
Okay. Mr. Jimit Shah is asking, do you have any technological collaboration?
No. We don't have. The knowledge which we have and the industry experiences is helping us to grow. But we don't have any collaborations. Because we tried getting some American products, ingredients here. But the conditions there and conditions here are totally different.
Okay.
So, all the products, all the technology is all made in India. So, on our drums and our pails, we always write proudly made in India. And we write the name of the operator who has done it.
Wow.
So, if the 26 liter pail or the thing is going out, they feel proud.
Correct.
That yes, I did something.
That is an amazing initiative, I would say.
Yes.
So, I think with this, all my questions are answered.
Yes.
I'm sure all our audience would have got their questions answered as well.
Yes.
Sorry, there is one more question. You have a good product line, but trying to get in touch with is difficult.
Trying to get in touch with me or with whom? You can.
So I will share the contact details of
Mr.
Amit Kaulgod with everybody.
Yeah, sure.
And then probably they can. It'll be easier.
Yes, definitely.
So, Amit, thank you very much for doing this.
Yeah, thank you very much.
And thank you everybody for joining in. This is the end of the session.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Oh, sorry. There is Mr. Akshay Zadav wants to ask something.
Okay.
Mr. Akshay, I think you can email us your question.
Yeah.
And then I will coordinate with Mr. Amit to answer that.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. I mean... Thank you, Mr. Virendra.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.